Yes, you can see.
Okay, so Manzi, but this is the shot. Okay, it was really nice that you how you got here, what you said, also your questions. If you
You should join them. Yeah. Since you are in the video.
So what's the concept?
Just think in the context.
Just be careful about this, yeah?
Yes. how was the video? Are you doing the project?
Okay.
Do you think we use mic?
So can you step?
Yes, it's okay.
Are you running?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, so you can see.
Okay, so Manzi, but this is the shot, okay? It was really nice that you how you got here, what you said, also your questions, if you can see here.
But bravo, it's music.
Nice, have to. I was amused.
Yeah,
you say more composed than the interviewer.
Crazy,
yeah, more composed.
Crazy.
Yeah. It's also crazy. So.
Yeah.
You can see also the weather is really nice. It's a blue skies as we created with the clouds. It's almost the same as it's today outside. Next time maybe we will bring some wind also, you know? So we can have like more wind later. Yeah.
Close-ups are earlier. Tady tohleto, this is ten, yeah. Musíš dát tu šipku zpátky. No, it was the second.
Okay.
The first one wasn't, didn't go well.
Oh yeah, it's the second take.
Really?
No.
Oh, where we are recording then?
Yes.
Oh, really? Same deal.
You only know two words, video sound.
Okay, that's it. With the YouTubers Po Drugi and wait a second.
Hello. So,
action for S. Sharon is action for you. And action.
How is Kibera? How can you describe Kibera?
So first, before I describe Kibera,
yes.
You didn't greet me the Kibera way.
Ah, how is it? How is
Niaji.
It? Ah, Niaji.
Ukopua.
Ukopua, una ninau.
Ukopua.
So that's Kibera Shien. Ukorien.
Ukorien by.
Ah, Wagwan. So, tell me about Kibera.
Okay.
Yes.
Kibera is my birthplace, my mother's land. It's where I belong. I was born here, raised here, went to school for some time, but life was hard. I stopped.
Ah, which level?
Class 3.
Wow, class 3. Okay. Then how did life, how was life at that time? What happened? What made you strong until you are here? If you drop out of school at class 3 level, you should be maybe somewhere devastating, but you're still strong.
I was devastated for 5 years.
You were devastated for 5 years?
Yeah, I was devastated for 5 years. I started being friends with bad girls, some are bad characters, yeah. But I thank God after 5 years I opened my eyes and I saw like I needed another chance. So I sat down, look at myself, look at where I was born, and I was like, this place, mm-hmm. you see the way it is still important also after 5 years of devotion. So it's my motherland. Okay, they call it dirty ugly, but I think this is the beauty of Kibera. If it was like this one, the neighbors, it couldn't be Kibera. So I looked at my motherland and I'm like, this place can really make me up.
I hear they call it the Chocolate City.
Chocolate City.
Because of the rusted iron sheets and stuff. Yeah. So
sewages, open sewages.
Oh, with the open sewages and stuff. Garbage. So why are this house congested? What brings this congestion?
This place is unplanned. Mm-hmm. It was unplanned for people to live. It was a forest with wild animals. So when there were some casual members of the wild people, so they were put here because they couldn't afford the good housing and everything. So when we came here, they gave birth, and that's how. So because they couldn't live in one house, so the kids, that's how the kids went.
It became
a community.
Meaning that these people, they are building these houses for themselves.
No, you can't build. You have to pay somebody again, 300 shillings.
Okay. Yeah. So they just decided this is now the formation of the houses and stuff.
Yeah.
This is how it became to be a children.
Yeah, so they stayed here. They built open sewages for us, open bathrooms. Yeah. But we survived. It's dangerous, but imagine we survived.
So let me ask, what's the biggest challenge for a girl child in Kibera? What's the biggest challenge? Shelter,
yeah.
The biggest challenge.
Yeah.
Why is shelter the biggest challenge?
So when I say shelter, you see this mud house, it's only maybe 700, 300.
A month.
There's smaller like this, 300 and 700, or maybe like this, 1500 maximum. So if she can't afford to live in such place, it means she's going to take the back seat of her. So that is the biggest challenge for the girl child. And when she doesn't have a place to live, she will go to a guy. That's how she will get. She will get kids and be another young mother.
Young mother. So the percentage of young mother will be better is high.
It's high, and they don't have job to do.
So are there any maybe actions that are put in case of anything that happens to make these young girls stuff? Do you have like measures put down on the list for these young mothers to protect them and stuff?
Yeah, some they hear and try to consider what you tell them. Some they are totally out of the way, so they can't be helped. That's why they end up sitting and living here without work. And without work, you send drugs to survive. Because also these people, they take some drugs sometimes.
Okay, so I see these are the now Kibera houses.
Yeah.
But you can observe like we have like three fancy buildings.
Uh-huh.
What do they mean?
These are our neighbors. I think they live from the aerial view. The birds do. So they capture the other side of Kibera is rich. We are at the center of rich people, Kare, Lakuton. We are at the center of rich.
And you can ask her. You can ask her that I'm surprised that you look sometimes like a fancy girl. How do you handle with this? And you can even turn into shape. You can start getting to more crazy with this. Just wait.
Manzi in Swahili means a girl. Then Kibera is a place. So it means a girl from Kibera. Why that name?
I have always wanted to represent my hood. So I look at all the names and I'm like, yeah, Manzi, a girl from the Kibera, Manzi Wa Kibera. And that's how the name is.
Okay. So Kibera. So I hear that Kibera language is kind of different. The Swahili is kind of different from from places to places in Kenya,
yes.
Like the Shieng, Niaje, Kokoa,
Unaninawo,
you see, Shieng like that. So how do you build this Shieng language and stuff in Kibera? How do you come up with this language?
Actually, exchange words.
Ah.
You can come from backwards to up, or you can take the first two letters, put at the center, and just you play with the words and you come out with a funny thing.
But people understand. Something you adapt easily and
We just adapt easily. Only it is the same thing, but we just do the ghetto way, you confuse the words.
But
to confuse the parents. It actually came to confuse the parents.
So that when the siblings are like talking and talking, the parents are not understanding.
They are not.
So it's a hidden language. It's just slang. Slang or something. I see.
Mm-hmm.
So Kibera is, I see Kibera is made of a lot of so many things and stuff. Before we even finish the interview, I wanted to know about something. I can see the sky is blue. Also, So this one represents what?
This one's
This blue one represents.
Yeah, we have two types of blue. We have the dark and the light.
Uh-huh.
So the light blue is the sewage. It's also the mushroom, the manini, my pampas, my garlic, spaghetti.
In a block.
So they come and mix with the Nairobi River.
The clean one.
Our main river for the city.
Uh-huh.
It passes through our ghetto. So
and this is the same water that is being
fish. We take fish from there, vegetables from there.
Okay.
See how?
But what I understand from a simple biology, if all this waste went to the river, it kills the fish.
Doesn't.
The fish from Africa are strong.
Yeah, even as you are there, if you don't die, why are the fishes dying?
Because you see this fish that block the circulation of oxygen inside the water, and it becomes difficult for the fish to survive. So it means that most of the fish that are affected are those ones that are floating on water already dead.
So these fishes, they are born and bred in the river of the ghetto. Yeah, so their immune is boosted right from that. Like the owners live there. So there's no single fish from Kilimani in Kibera. If a fish from Kilimani comes, it will die immediately if it steps on the mixed water.
Wow, it's very nice having this talk with you. Kibera is very interesting, as I can see.
And
it's
food also itself.
You sell food? Okay, because lastly I've been walking fast through Kibera and I see like any place is a marketplace. Anywhere, even if sewage is passing through there, even if water is passing through there, there's market everywhere. So why is that, and do you have like restrictions considering your health standards and stuff, or just do it because of just
what I know is that Kibera residents are boosted naturally by God. Yeah, So what happens, we don't get sick a lot. We have a problem of water, latrine, bathroom, everything. But we don't get sick. So there's nothing like poison in Kibera or germs. We don't really recognize those vaccines.
So since you mentioned about the problem with the toilet and stuff, so meaning where do you deposit your waste and stuff?
In the sewage, those ones.
Like you go and stand there,
yeah,
remove your clothes, do your business.
Yeah, nobody
cares. In front of everyone.
Because there's no toilet.
Wow.
No single landlord has a toilet for them. Okay, where can we put a toilet in you? Because it's a mixed up of houses.
Okay, I also heard about this kind of toilet, known as the flying toilet.
Yeah.
I don't know. Can you explain to us what it means?
That one flies all the way to this high-rise unit.
So they go and put their waste inside a polythene bag. Then they roll it and
roll it.
Anyway it lands.
To Amsterdam. Yeah.
Anyway it lands.
Amsterdam,
so it can land on someone's face. It's just normal.
It lands Amsterdam direct. This is Amsterdam.
So someone is accurate to throw it inside the
Rotterdam. This is Rotterdam.
Wow. Well, that's very interesting and fascinating. So it's been nice talking to you. There's a lot of story about Kibera. It's very nice. And, people are nice. They are humble like you. And much more needs to be done here. And as we finish this interview, well, would you like better to change, or we just love it the way it is?
It should change, for sure. We should have such houses.
Okay.
Yeah, but maybe they charge us 2,000.
They more than 2,000, like $2,000 a month.
Yeah, plus electricity, big latrine included. Because it is expensive every day to go with 10 shillings.
10 shillings per person.
Yeah, and if you eat a lot like I do, you have to go 5 times. 50 shillings is how much per month?
$1,500. Yeah. $15 a month, just for toilets.
$15 plus $15.
$30 for
nice one.
Wow, it's been nice talking to you. And I hope we get to know more about you better.
That's why I'm here.
I will move in soon.
Oh,
how much is the house? $10.
$10 is a lot. $3.
$3? You are leaving?
Yeah.
A whole month?
Not leaving. You are sleeping and
wow.
You have a house before you.
$3.
$3.
Wow. Okay. Thank you so much. That was great.